If you need to make a path over a small river or stream, a simple wooden plank is enough. As the river widens, you need to add piers, meaning bridge pillars, in between. By adding these piers, you can build a large river crossing bridge. However, if the river is navigable, meaning ships pass through, you need to provide clear space in the middle. In a smart way, you remove the piers and hang the bridge deck with cables that are directly connected to the bridge tower. This is called a cable-stayed bridge, like a person lifting a plank. The person becomes the bridge tower, the cables are the bindings, and the plank is the bridge deck. Now suppose that river becomes even wider than the cables of the cable stayed bridge. The cables would need to be quite long and thick, which becomes very expensive and less efficient. Now you adopt a new method. On the bridge towers, two massive main cables are hung, and from them, the bridge deck is suspended in segments. This structure's weight begins to pull the towers slightly inward. If you connect cables from the opposite side or then these main cables, and extend it outward to maintain balance. Now it seems like two people are lifting a plank with their hands. Where the people are, bridge towers, tied are, suspension cables and the hanging ropes are, vertical suspenders. The plank is still the bridge deck. This is the suspension bridge. Its high deck allows large ships to pass, but such tall bridge towers can interfere with airplane routes. Now you take a bold step, stop building the bridge and the road. Take it underwater. Although underwater construction is extremely challenging, you adopt the steel-encased concrete method. First, rust-resistant steel shells are made, then concrete is poured into them, and they are joined together to create a tunnel. Now you connect this tunnel to the bridge you previously built. Congratulations, you have created the Shenzhen Junction link, such a mega infrastructure project
that smartly combines the bridge and tunnel. Please like and subscribe.